Yeah, what would you say? You know, like when we talk about changing dynamics, it's also that we don't have lip sync songs as much as we used to in the past. You know, most of them take the story forward or are sort of immersed into the narrative. Don't you think like that's a better way to go about it?
I think so, and I think that, like I always say, the audience strangely, you know, there was a time that you could, and no offense to the audience that was there 15 years ago when I started, but there was a time that, you know, they could get swayed. But right now, songs, music is very essential to, yeah, you know, like they say, picture ko garam karna hai, you've got to spread the message. I love Bollywood music. The only time I hit dance floor at a party, no matter how drunk or sober I am, I only do it when there's Hindi music going on. So yes, one thing is, music is an essential part of our society. The fact that all of us love Indian music, there's Indian population all over the world. I've been to clubs in Singapore where they've only played Hindi music. All of that is great. The other side of it is, the audience is like, chal yaar, gana shuru ho gaya, ab popcorn le aate hain, chal abhi bathroom ho aate hain, you know, so, and we invest sometimes as people in the business and filmmakers and producers, sometimes invest more in that one song where they're going to get up and have popcorn than we've done in the entire film. I mean, actresses spend 6 months in the gym for that one song as opposed to, you know, spending 6 hours in the gym for the entire film. Like, you know, there's a flip side.
Or an acting school.
Or an acting school. Like, there will be 4 months of dance rehearsals, but there will be no readings whatsoever. But I'm just saying there's a flip side and a funny side to it altogether. The reason why we're all here is because you guys should know everything. You're entitled to know it. But having said that, I mean, if it's, again, Dangal, great way of putting music in. Shashank, I love your films, I love the music. That song from Badri, Badri Ki Dulaniya is my number one track on my jogging list. Like, it's my warm-up song, as amazing or as ridiculous that as it sounds.
You know, talking about people and songs, okay. You know what was the number one biggest criticism of Humpty Sharma Ki Dulaniya by the, I'm talking about two-tier and three-tier cities, that end mein jo Saturday gaana aata hai na, wo apne full screen pe kyun nahi rakha? That was the number one criticism of Humpty Sharma Ki Dulaniya from distributors and exhibitors from two-tier and three-tier cities, because audiences are getting upset that along with half the screen, there is a rolling credits happening. Please keep it full screen. We are living in our own country. We should accept what it is. And when we're talking about a changing dynamic, it is about saying that, okay, let's have some more logic into it.
Yeah,
let's say we can have some more about, as she mentioned, empowerment. It's also about saying that, you know what, I'm going to use whatever intelligence I have and use it. It might not be great intelligence, it might not be limited, but this is my understanding of New Age cinema. I'm going to make it this way.
But you know, I've also heard of, and I don't know if I should be like spilling all the beans, but across the table I've heard of a really big A-lister stars film being made, and it was a sequel to a really big film, and they were like, chalo panch gaane dal diye, ye ho gaye 25 minute, panch action sequence hai, ye 25 minute aur 50 minute ho gaye aur bacha 1 ghanta 10 minute, aise karte ki acche writer ko bula ke na 1 ghanta 10 minute karke hum picture bana denge. So this kind of stuff,
did that
also
work?
No, but
exactly.
The part one worked and the part two didn't work, and it was a huge star who was in the film, and it's just, I mean, sometimes films are made like this, and then sometimes there are films that are based on research for like 4 years and 5 years that are made, and I'm telling you, it pays off, it shows, and the audience definitely laps up to it. Sometimes you don't even get to know. Like, what was that film that Mukti Bhavan? Like, I mean, it's amazing how, you know, everybody started talking about it, again, mentioning lipstick, timing, controversy, social media. Everything adds up nowadays, you know.
Yeah, as a producer, what would you say about the idea of remixing old songs, you know, whether it's from the 90s? Shashank, I believe you had two songs in Badri that were, the title was from Teesri Kasam, I think.
We actually used, the first film that we made, Love Breakup Zindagi, we used Maise Meena Se. And which is, you remember that Neelam and Govinda song? So I, Sahil and I, who Sahil of course is my husband now, but at that time he was my director and co-producer, and we had grown up on this song. It was an 80s big blockbuster song. Actually, it had gone under the radar in the 80s. And we both loved that song. And when we needed to design a sequence for the weddings in the film, We of course had Javed Saab write amazing lyrics in Rab Rakha, and that kind of explored the dynamics of festivity in a wedding through the sequences of the wedding in the film. But when we wanted to do the wedding Sangeet performance, in real life, we always choose a song that we identify with, that we, you know, that we've loved or want to perform to. So we identified Main Se Meena Se, and it was remixed, but without corrupting the soul of the composition. Yeah, we didn't mess with the composition, the essence of the composition. I think there was a few more grooves and beats added to just up the tempo a little, but otherwise we didn't mess with the song at all. And I think that was a conscious decision we made because we didn't want to ruin the beauty of the original track. And we really enjoyed performing to it. And I know a lot of people who watched the film really loved the song because it kind of brings a sense of nostalgia. You really love it. And speaking about Tamma Tamma, that was again a song that we grew up to. We loved dancing to it as children. And it was really cool to see Varun and Alia bring that song back to us.
Also give you a perspective on Tamma Tamma. When the song got finalized, when I heard the song, I said, I love Tamma Tamma. I wanted it in the film. Karan loved it. The two actors I'm working with next, they are 19, 20 years old. I said, you know what, we are recreating Tamma Tamma. And they were looking blankly at me. They were blank. I said, you don't know Tamma Tamma. They've never heard of it. They've never heard of it. So, you know,
introducing an iconic song.
There is a different generation.
Heard of Tamma Tamma. I mean, these guys are beyond millennials.
They are
millennials.
You know, so that's what I'm trying to tell you, you know. We tend to believe as at our age that, you know, this is done. At our age, we're like, you know what, everyone's heard it. That's not the truth. You know, generation gap is no more 10 years. Generation gap is now happening after every 3 to 4 years. Like, my younger sister is about 7 years younger to me. It's tough to have conversations, you know, because I'm like, have you seen TV? And she's like, I haven't seen TV for 3 weeks. I'm like, why? Because she's like, I'm consuming everything on the net. You know, I need the newspaper every morning. She does not need she has never read the newspaper.
But isn't,
all her content. So it's a different generation.
But isn't that great, Shashank, that everything, you know, we have to understand one other problem with content, and then of course everything being consumed as far, you know, in your palm, is that the world has become flat. Like, there were series that would come into India. I still remember when 24 came out, I bought the DVD box set of it. Because,
DVDs.
Yeah, what are DVDs? Exactly. Great question. Now, Game of Thrones releases in India at the same time. The world is flat. India is not behind. We don't have time difference. That's another main, you know, it's a very core issue where people are like, hey, let's not go to the theatres. Ghar mein jab aayegi, tab hum dekhenge picture. We decide instantly. And because I'm just like, listen, I want to be, there were like 5 films that came out and I was just like, should I go watch this? Or should I stick to watching Game of Thrones, Ozark, this, that? There were like 15 other options that I had. But I was just like, no, I'm going to consume great content sitting at home. So if we're not going to be at par, we're not going to be able
to touch
to,
with the young audience.
Yeah. And you know, it's not like in the West when there's content that was being made for television, which started much earlier, the writing was at par with cinema, you know, so we need to get ahead.
No, it's gotten better. Like,
you know, I'll tell you this perspective on songs, you know.
I would trust that.
Wait a minute. So you go to Singapore and you go to the nightclub and you make out and you don't dance.
It's a really important meaning. And then the guy said, 3 seconds, family audience disturbed. I said, how can they get disturbed? Isn't that the reason we're all in the world? That's how we came in, right?
I don't think so.
We came in with the song and dance.
Yeah,
we didn't come in with the sex scene.
Trust me, if my parents were holding two flowers and just touching them, nothing would have happened. Right? So the point is, really, hopefully, Well, he's out now. Now we'll speak to Prasun, sir. But my point is, if we had other elements, and everyone needs commerce, you know, and that's the truth. You can also read about it. I read about it. That's what Hollywood did. There are a lot of scenes you will see in Hollywood where they use sex and nudity endlessly. And we use songs. This is our commerce, you know. In the song only we imagine things.
Quickly jump in here. There's one element that we must acknowledge because it's very important part of our storytelling. One is, why do we rehash old songs, reproduce them? Interesting point brought forward that it's reintroducing it to a new generation. And if it's done well, it's always good to happen. The other thing is, maybe songs have been used as an escape route because we've not been allowed the playing field to express the emotions that we actually want to express. But there's another very, very important thing about our songs, and I discovered this working with filmmakers like Rajkumar Hirani, where he would beat himself up trying to find the right lyrics to convey a thought. And I know this, like film after film he's done this, and there are a lot of filmmakers in our country who take their music very seriously. Songs for them are thoughts that they're introducing through their cinema.
As long as it's that.
There's no hard and fast rule, that's what I'm saying. That it can be a relief, it can be to generate or auger a familiarity or an attention from a younger audience. It may be an opportunity to make somebody dance at a wedding or at a nightclub. And in many cases, it's also an opportunity to express within a limited span of time something that you really care to express in a beautiful, heightened manner.
Yeah, I get that, but as long as the songs provoke thought or, you know, are written, but I don't think so a Chikni Chameli or, you know, a Favicol is doing
it. It provokes a lot of thoughts.
What are you thoughts?
Chikni Chameli gives you more thoughts than any other love song.
Sorry? Absolutely.
You know, for example, just to get a bit pompous, if I can, I thought Main Tenu Samjhava Ki was a beautifully short video. It had a great emotion about that.
I have to say that, you know,
and if the music company is very happy with you, you'll get more money for the producer, then he'll become happy and your next film will have more money. That's how you break the commercial cycle as well.
Okay, I'll give you another example.
But then aren't we 1 minute? But then what you just said, Shashank, it's still like, you know, we're going back a full circle. Like, you know, the whole point is we start this conversation discussing films like Newton and all of that. And now we're saying that, okay.
Celebrating Chikni Chameli.
Yeah, we said, that's what it is. You know, we are now saying huge applause for Chikni Chameli. Nothing wrong with Chikni Chameli.
My point is enjoy both.
Which is okay, but you know, when he started off saying that films aren't doing well, and the films that haven't done well have had amazing music, like, it's best I don't name films that haven't done well, we all know.
And you
know, amazing music songs have not done very well.
But that's what I'm saying, no, films have had great music, some films have had, like, you know, women looking amazing, pole dancing and doing other things, but those films don't do well. What do?
You try harder.
That's exactly what I'm saying. You try harder, not on the pole. You try harder on the writing desk. That's what you need to do.
See, I'll tell you what. I come from a very honest perspective. My thing is, make the film you want to make. And I mean, all jokes apart, write the script you understand. Write that script. If you write it with a certain amount of conviction and belief in yourself, and if you feel that the moments are true, it will connect to people. That's my honest belief towards it. That's it really. That's what I can say, because every time I write a scene in my movie, I believe that there's certain emotion to it which is connecting to people. And that's the reason they are connecting
to people. So be honest with them. Exactly. Honesty. Yeah. If you did Chikni Chameli with honesty, you wouldn't be Chikni Chameli.
For example, when I saw Kapoor and Sons, it's a Dharma film, when I saw Kapoor and Sons, Anjum Rajapali sir is in the house and I should shut up because he's sitting looking at me right now and he's like, "Tu bahut baatein kar raha hai, maine tere ko sab sikhaya writing ke bare mein." Sir, really sorry, all I'm talking. Now I can't talk, now you can, the stage is too open.